The British English Language.
British English.
The Universal Declaration of Human Rights.
All human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. They are endowed with reason and conscience and should act towards one another in the spirit of brotherhood.
Numbers.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Greetings and phrases.
Hello. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening. Good night. Bye. Goodbye. Yes. No. Maybe. Okay. Thank you. You're welcome. Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Vocabulary.
Aeroplane. Apologize. Catalog. Centimeter. Color. Enroll. Favorite. Gray. Organize. Program. Theater. Traveled. Football. City center. Autumn. Shop. Wardrobe. Cinema. Shop assistant. Ground floor. Car park. Fortnight. Pavement. Bill. Trainers. Waistcoat. Chips. Crisps. Biscuit. Courgette. Aubergine. Flat. Underground. High street. Takeaway. Rubber. Post. Mummy. Holiday. Lift. Nappy. Telly. Sweets. Candy floss. Torch. Mobile phone. Rubbish. Bin. Postal code. Petrol.
In the beginning.
We live in a beautiful world. Just look at the wonderful things around you. Let's go back to the beginning and see what the Bible tells us about how it all began. In the beginning, God made the heavens and the earth. God moved over the darkness and said, "Light." He called the light day, and he called the darkness night. And that was that for day one. Then God made a space to separate the waters above from the waters below. He called the space sky, and that was that for day two. God gathered the waters together, and dry ground appeared. He called the ground land, and the waters seas. Then he made plants like grass, grain, and trees, and that was that for day three. Then God made lights in the sky. He made the sun for the day, the moon for the night, and all the stars. And that was that for day four. God made fish to swim in the waters and birds to fly in the sky. "Have babies," he told them. "Fill the world with splashing and singing." And that was that for day five. Next, God made animals. He made farm animals, wild animals, and animals that crawl on the ground. "Just one more thing to make," God said, "the most special thing of all." So, in his image, God made man and woman. "Have babies," he said, "and look after this world. Care for the fish, the birds, and the animals." And that was that for day six. Then God looked at everything he had made. "It's very good," he said. So on the seventh day he rested and made that day special. And that was that.
The wren.
The wren used to have his nest in the car shed. Once the old ones had both flown out, they had wanted to get something to eat for their young and had left the little ones all alone. After a while, Father Wren returns home. "What's happened here?" he says. "Who harmed you children? You are all terrified." "Oh, Dad," they say, "some big bogeyman came by just now. He looked so fierce and horrible. He stared into our nest with his big eyes. That scared us so." "I see," Father Wren says. "Where did he go?" "Well," they say, "he went down that way." "Wait," Father Wren says. "I'll be after him. Don't you worry now, children. I'll get him." Thereupon he flies after him. When he comes around the bend, it is the lion who is walking along there. But the wren is not afraid. He alights on the lion's back and starts scolding him. "What business do you have coming to my house," he said, "and terrifying my children?" The lion pays no attention to it. and keeps walking. That makes the little loudmouth berate him even more fiercely. You have no business being there, I tell you. And if you come back, he said, well, then you'll see. I don't really want to do it, he said, and finally lifts one of his legs. But I'd break your back with my leg in a second. Thereupon, he flies back to his nest. There you go, children, he says. I've taught that one a lesson. He won't be back.